Hi guys, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. In the previous video, we have seen how bad Android architecture looks like. In this video, we will get started with implementing a very basic MVC architecture in Android. Well, to do that, the first thing that we have got to do is separate the view and controller from the activity. And of course, the model is already separated. So before continuing with how are we going to implement the controller and view, we will right now mainly concentrate on the model. If you recall our to-do application, there are basically four operations with respect to model that we need to be concerned about. One is to get hold of all to-dos in our database so that they need to be rendered, and then you need to add to-do to the database, remove to-do from the database, and then modify to-do from the database. The way I am going to do this is I will create interface called as MVCModel. So any of the custom models that you want to implement will be either implementation or extension of this interface. So you can clearly see that I have four methods defined in this particular interface, and then I will have a MVC model implementer class which actually implements these methods. It will be using to-do list DB adapter. So talking purely from the object-oriented programming perspective, MVC model is the top interface. The MVC model implementer implements the MVC model interface, and then MVC model implementer has a instance of to-do list DB adapter which has got database related implementations. So let's try to understand by having a look at the code. As you can see here, I have defined a package called as model, and under the package you have bean class, which is a to-do class, and then you have a DB package. Inside that I have a to-do list DB adapter, and other than that, the main class that is under the discussion here is MVC model. If you can observe here, I have this MVC model defined as interface. It has got method get all to do's. Other than that, we have add to do item, remove to do item, and modify to do item. If you want to see the implementation hierarchy of this particular interface, it will show the MVC model implementer class which actually implements MVC model. And if you would like to have a look at the structure, it implements get to do method, add to do item, remove to do item, modify to do item methods. So let's see the model implementation looks like. It has got to do list DB adapter, which is the database adapter, and it also maintains a list of to do items, and it has got a method called as refresh, which is a private method which refreshes the to do list items that are there in the class. And then if you have a look at the implementation of interface methods, get all to do's returns to do items, and then add to do item just invokes the insert method on the DB adapter, and based on the return type of the boolean, whether it is a successful insertion or a failure, it will refresh the value or it will throw an exception. And then when you do a remove to do item, once again we do a delete invocation on the DB adapter, and the return type is a boolean, and depending upon whether it is a success, I either refresh it or I throw another exception. And the same is applicable to modify to do item, and in this case also I am invoking the modify method over the to do list DB adapter, and it returns me a boolean variable, and based on whether that particular boolean value is a success, I either refresh or throw a exception. So this is how the MVC model implementation looks like. Now the next part is we need to understand the implementation of controller. As I had explained in the previous video, task of controller is handle event handling on the screen or any of the navigations that are supposed to happen in the app. In our application, there's only one single screen, and on that screen there are multiple buttons. So it's all about handling what should happen when on add button is clicked or remove button is clicked, modify button is clicked. Not only this, what should happen when the screen itself is loaded, or in other words, on view loaded, what needs to happen. So these will be the typical methods that you would be needing in the controller. So what it means in terms of code? Well, once again, you will be having a class or an interface. In this case, I have implemented the class itself. This particular class has got methods like onViewLoaded, onAddButtonClicked, onRemoveButtonClicked, and onModifyButtonClicked. So let's have a look at the code. There is a package called as controller, and under that I have got a class called as MVCController. It has got methods like onViewLoaded, onAddButtonClicked, onRemoveButtonClicked, and onModifyButtonClicked. Other than that, it has got two instance variables. One is an instance of MVCModel, and another one is an instance of MVCView. MVCModel is needed to actually carry out the database operations. We will have a look at MVCView later, but just try to understand what we are doing in the methods of controller. In the onViewLoaded, I am invoking some methods from the MVCView, and the data that I am supplying to the MVCView is from MVCModel. And this is exactly the same template you will see across all the methods that are defined in this particular class. If you have a look at onAddButtonClicked, I am invoking some method on the MVCModel, and based on that particular success, I am updating something on the MVCView. You need not worry about how the MVCView is implemented, because we will be discussing later. Just try to understand that the controller is invoking some method on the model. Depending upon what is the return type of the model, we are updating the view. The same is applicable in case of on remove button clicked and on modify button clicked. Well, if we try to represent the communication template between controller and model, it basically looks like you have controller and model. Controller invokes some method from the model, and model basically informs the controller back with the new set of data. This is basically the distilled version of what you saw in the code. Now comes the view. Well, what are the responsibilities that you can think of in our application that view needs to manage? One is initialize the UI elements. It needs to show all the to-dos when the application launches for the first time. And then it needs to update the view on addition of the new to-do. In the same way, whenever we do remove, modify, we need to update the UI. And if there are any errors, we need to show the appropriate errors on the screen. You need to bind the data to the different UI elements. It's very easy to say that these are the view's responsibilities, but our view is not a normal view. At the end of the day, our view is getting rendered in an activity. The main challenges that you will see here are how to separate the layout inflation from the activity, how to separate the view instantiation from the activity, how to set the event listeners away from the activity, and last but not the least, how does the life cycle of the activity plays into all of this. So these are some of the very basic things that we need to think about when we decide to separate the view from the activity. We shall see how to do this in the next video. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.